I think the first thing you can just see when you get to school, where there's a lack of leadership, you can see in school the environment itself is not being. You can see learners all over the show. That on its own just tell you that the school has no stable leadership. It's obvious when a child also check, it's confirmed that there is no permanent principal. They are doing rotation in terms of acting. That on its own tells you that it's a problem. Obviously, when you look at the infrastructure, the school is old, it's aging. I think it needs to be maintained regularly, which is a challenge. You can see the classes here. So we are saying about 7 of these classrooms here are not being used. But over and above that, the classes also behind are also not being used. But I think it's also because of the numbers that the school has lost more learners. That on its own is a challenge because, you know, we can't say we don't have more learners as we speak. There's still learners who are not placed in certain areas because of preference of particular schools. So it's a pattern where if the school is not well managed, parents, they go to their feet and take their kids out of that school. But then they put pressure on particular schools who are doing well. We need to ensure that all schools are competitive so that we can share the same load, unlike what we're seeing here. I mean, another challenge is that people are staying at the school premises. And these are not people who are working at the school. So at least it was really justifiable when people stay and still looking after the school itself. But what we observe on the side, it's a challenge. I'm going to take this matter with the MEC so that there's something which needs to be done. Because the acting principal has indicated that orders, they've tried their best, but there's nothing which is coming forth. So I'm going to engage with the MEC just to establish if this matter has been brought to the department, how far are they with it, and when are they going to inform it. You know, there are no people staying at the school premises who are not working at the school. Because it causes a safety issue. You know, if kids get raped, they'll be up in arms, running up and down, and saying, you know what, this must not have happened. But we're allowing it to be, you don't become repetitive. Some of the things need to be, you know, proactive and say we need to accommodate, I mean, to ensure that this school, I mean, learners and even teachers are all safe. Because even if the people are staying and coming in, you know, they might be visiting those families. You don't know who they are, they're not vetted, they've got access on the other side. So that on its own is a challenge. So we're going to take this matter up. With the word councillor, you know, she is also trying to do her best in getting the community. So how best can we ensure that this school is operating functionally in this world? There are a series of issues which are brought to our children through her, like, you know, which are happening to the school today. People are feeling unsafe to even be called, because they say, if we go, who's going to take this matter up? So part of the school safety strategy that they're dealing with such matters. So that's what I'm saying, when I'm taking up with the MEC, just to follow up and see how far we are processing the matter.
Do you know how councillor can just elaborate on some of the issues that
Yes, and sure. So, of course, as the board councillor, I am not on the side kind of stops when it comes to school. So thankful for that, because the surrounding community, and that's where I got involved, is very worried about the future of these children attending the school, because some of them attend, most of them living in the area attended the school themselves back in what they would call the glory days. So they've agreed to set up a committee where the residents are going to volunteer their time and efforts to assist the school in whichever way necessary. So I'll be communicating with the SGB's chair and with the principal and the committee, and we're going to assist. At the moment, there's already a community members assisting with security in the school. They've replaced palisades. So the community wants to help, but it's obviously a very intricate and complex situation. I'm very thankful for the Shadow MEC who's now going to take up some of these serious matters further. In terms of people living here, we'll also have to sort of consult with the city's social development department, but of course we need to follow that process, the eviction process, which in itself requires you to find a technical alternative accommodation. So wherever I can assist with those kind of things, there is to be already reached out to me on it, I'll do that.
We
Sure, it's Chantal Furie Shaw. It's a double barrel, so Furie-Shaw.